there are two things which I hold very tightly. You know, Ramana Maharshi has written only two prose pieces himself. That too when he was, you know, when he had that realization. One is Who Am I? The other one is Self-Inquiry. So this is my, literally like my Bible. I only, you know, go through this because it was from a young man who was not conditioned, who did not have any religious, you know, upbringing or background, and who just, it came on its own. So it's in my opinion the purest form of learning that one can get. So I typically go follow him and sort of get back to whatever experience I have, you know, sort of check back to whatever he has written or whatever was transcribed from what he had said, because he had not written it, it only spoken in words. So there, you know, some of these lines, every time I read I get a different meaning. And
the greatest proof will be when you somehow don't remember Ramana Maharshi and are still able to be what he said. You said you have your own thoughts, concepts and life, and you kind of match it against what he is saying.
No, what? No, what I'm saying is, in his case, it happens spontaneously, very naturally. In my case, I've got so much of conditioning which has happened over a period of time. So many concepts which have all gone inside. So, I have to shed it.
Even Ramana Maharshi, even a Krishna, carries his share of conditioning. It is just that he does not give it central importance. Till the time you keep saying you are conditioned, you will remain conditioned. Stop taking this statement too seriously. Because Ramana Maharshi too had his to know one language and not to know another language. To have one kind of genetic features and not have another kind of genetic features. Huh? All these things remain. But to say, to see that these are not important, that is when you and Ramana Maharshi come really close. The idea can never be to emulate him. It must always be to disappear just like him.
Yes, exactly. This is exactly, you know, what I do get this, you know, feeling once in a while, but I'm not able to, what should I say? I'm not able to believe that this is real.
When it happens, then it is so damn mighty and crazy and overwhelming that you say, no, 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 it cannot be real. The truth is dying to come to you. And when it comes, you say, no, no, this cannot be the truth. Ramana Maharshi does not do that. When it comes, he says, all right, I knew you had to come. Now that you have come, wonderful. That is the only difference. It comes to everybody. We refuse to believe him. We are faithless beings. Ramana Maharshi just opens his door. He says, welcome, welcome. We doubt.
Jnana is not a progressive thing. It does not come that, you know, one chapter a day, second chapter a day. It comes, you know, in one lot. You know, it just comes to you and then you, it's a path which is irreversible.
He is not saying this in time. He is not saying that it comes to you once in time. All that he means is that it is not a process, thereby meaning that it is not something in time. Jnana is not something in time means Jnana is not material. That is all that he means. It does not mean that something will happen to you once and then it will continue. He is not talking of continuation. Spirituality has nothing to do with continuation. It has everything to do with cessation.
So we sometimes talk about the burning, right? So you burn what you are not, right? So that's a gradual process. Whereas what he says is, jnana comes, you know, in one shot. Right, so there is a type of
even burning is one shot.
Burning is it one shot?
That which is something is here. Suppose this is full. I'm drinking. That which I'm drinking right now. The next sip will be in the next moment, and these two moments are not related. Only when one moment is related to the other moment do you call it time. Time means possession. Time means past and future. If the so-called next moment is not at all related to the previous moment, then it is not time. Then it is grace. So something has been burnt at 1 p.m. Something has been burnt at 2 p.m. But if what is happening at 2 p.m. is not an effect of what happened at 1 p.m., then these two must be called spontaneous and complete activities in themselves. None of them is then incomplete.
So they are not related?
They are not related, and hence they are total in themselves. That does not mean that everything got burnt at 1 p.m. No. It kept burning from 1 p.m. till 6 p.m. But because it is happening due to grace, so what burnt at 5 p.m. had nothing to do with what burnt at 2 p.m. It is uncaused, na? 5 has nothing to do with 4, 4 has nothing to do with 3. It is, 4 is not a cause of 5. What is a cause of 5? What is happening at 5 p.m. is not being caused by what is happening at 4 p.m.
So it's not a continuous process, it's a discrete.
So the 5 p.m. thing is being caused by grace. The 4 p.m. thing is also being caused by
grace.
So they both are not interlinked.